Somebody lived here once. Dolores. Something here. A chest.
What?
Got anything interesting? Farewell.
Gloria was still unwell. Head's hot as a hearth, and she's seeing things.
Ought to take her into the swamp to see the sisters.
And how would I repay them? You know I've been eating Barkroth since the new moon.
Sisters don't want food.
What then?
You'll see.
You, white one, what's your business? Bloody Baron know you're here?
Hear about the job. Seems you got a problem. Some graves get dug up.
If that were only it. Every now and then, a vile beast would come round the graveyard, devour what's fresh, then move on. Started again not long past. Thought to myself, just don't step out after dark and lock your door tight. But then a young'un went missing.
From the graveyard?
Nay, from the village. Little snotter wouldn't have come here of his own. And I'd heard something like a whimper in the night.
Didn't bother to come out, see what was happening?
Think me daft? If you've monsters, you need a witcher.
Let's talk about my reward.
Rate's fair, considering the job. I know a bit about these things.
See if I can learn what's out there.
Not at all.
Dug up the graves. Then the stench of decay attracted wild dogs. But neither ghouls nor dogs steal kids. Dug up. No tools used, though. Graves been dug up. Recently. Smell of cadaverines old, though. Overripe. Wonder where the stench will lead me. Filth lives here, sure chose an unusual place for its lair.
Creature can use tools. Means it's sapient, or just plain clever.
Human skulls in a magic circle. Monsters clearly using them, drawing strength from the place of power. Somebody's doing some cooking. This, it's a human femur. A child's. Gotta be a grave hag. Collected the skulls to draw the power through them. Confidence grew enough it started prowling the village. Need to take the skulls, force it to go back to the cemetery. I'll get it there.
That ought to really piss it off. Now to lay low in the cemetery. It's likely to crawl out after dark.
Soon.
There she is, right on cue.
Ah!
That's it, Roach.
Hear about the job.
And?
It's taken care of. It was a grave hack that dug up the graves and snatched the child.
Aye? So, how is the little tyke?
Found him in the grave hag's lair. In her cauldron, to be precise. Want me to go on?
I not even said that much.
What about my reward?
Oh, I've not forgotten, nay. Here you go. Thanks much for your help.
Take care.
Come on, Roach. Let's go! Whoa there, Roach.
Doug went in the kitchen, stole a hunk of meat.
Cook gave him a licking, strung him by his feet.
Cook then bled him empty, stripped his skin off clean.
Laughed and said, "How tasty, best sausage I have seen."
Cook's a stupid killer, shouldn't have ate the pup.
Now we'll light a fire, gonna roast him up. 1, 2, 3, the one to fetch the kindlings, thee!
Interesting rhyme.
Don't know you. Go away.
What are you doing out here alone?
We's not alone. We's with Gran.
But where did you all come from?
We's orphans.
All of you?
There's a war, so there's orphans. Didn't know that.
I'm looking for the witches of Crookback Bog.
You look like a witch yourself. Witches? Of the bog.
We can't go in the bog. Gran don't let us.
When my brother Zemek went missing, Gran said it was because he went in the woods and got lost. Gran cried an awful lot after that.
He could still come back.
A young woman got lost in the swamp. She has ashen hair and a scar on her face. You kids see anyone like that?
Ain't no lassies here.
What am I?
You're no lassie. Lassie's got tits.
They do. Heard an old man say once, when the army was here, he says, "Hide them lassies in the woods. They's dazzling the soldiers with their tits. And it's torturing the poor lads." That's what he said.
Listen. The girl I'm looking for, she's in trouble. I understand you might not want to help me, but you could try to help her.
How do you know she was here?
I heard she visited the witches in the swamp.
But there's no witches here.
There's only frogs.
And snakes.
And Johnny.
What's this talk? What kind of jabbering is this, eh? No one allowed here. Just kids. My kids. They're allowed. But who are you, wearing swords like a bandit?
You look after these kids?
They're my grandchildren.
Gran's good to us. Gonna be soup with scratchings for supper.
Kids get lost in the woods. I miss them. Seen them in the woods? No one has.
Who's Johnny?
Johnny ate a cat. Come the moor in some furry shat.
Watch your language. Tails and tails, naught but tails.
Are you one of the witches of the swamp? I hear Crookback Bog.
Witch? Me? Nay, I've no broom nor owl and not one wart on me nose. Got a pretty nose, see?
Gran's got a lovely beak.
Oh, you darling girl. Our kids are so sweet.
Just talking to the kids. Asked them if they'd seen a young woman.
Oh, I was a lovely young woman. Wore a long, beautiful braid my mummy did up for me. Had dresses with flowers on them.
Maybe you've seen her. Young, ashen hair.
Your betrothed?
Daughter, actually.
Daughter? My dear, sweet little daughter and her sister. Where are they now? Maybe they've come to some harm.
Had about enough of this. Asked a simple question. You seen the woman or haven't you?
Fear not, children.
There's nought to fear, Gran. He's only angry because he cares.
Maybe Johnny knows something. I'll take him to Johnny before he goes barmy on us.
Johnny's your invention, and you shouldn't be using those ugly words. To the hut. Go on now. You'll stand in the corner, I'll make sure you do. And you, stop scaring the little ones. Now go. Be gone.
Can't come in here. Not allowed in here.
I just want to talk to the boy.
Not allowed. It's not allowed.
He won't talk to you anyway. Gran don't like you. And Johnny's made up. And strangers steal kids.
Just tell me where I can find Johnny.
Johnny's made up.
Be gone. Be gone.
Why don't you want to talk about Johnny? One of you knows about him. The others must too.
It's just him who's pals with Johnny. They pick mushrooms and hunt snails. But Gran says Johnny's made up.
Have any of you ever seen Johnny?
Of course. Looks just like him.
Then why do you say he's made up?
Gran says so. And Gran knows lots.
Does your Gran treat you right? She ever hurt you?
Never.
When we're bad, she cries.
She's scared. Says strangers might take us. And we'll disappear.
The boy who plays with Johnny, he must be brave.
Not brave, just stupid.
Sat his bare bum on an anthill once. But yeah, he plays with Johnny. He don't listen to Gran and goes in the woods, and then he's got to have a time out.
And he eats snails. Yuck.
The girl I mentioned is in danger. You gotta help me get your Gran away from the hut so I can talk to Johnny's friend.
All right, but you gotta do something for us, too. Play hide and seek. Gran never does. Says her feet hurt.
Let's play. You hide,
But if I find you, you have to help me talk to the boy who knows Johnny.
He thinks he'll find us easy.
Means he's never hid from the black ones.
No looking, and you have to count out loud. All your fingers, toes, too.
1, 2, 3, 18, 19, 20. Ready or not, here I come. Found you. You can stop hiding.
How'd you find me? See you. Come out. There you are. Looks like rain. No one left hiding.
You're a wizard, right? Gonna show us some tricks when we get to the cottage.
No, we'll talk about your promise. Found you all. Now you gotta keep your word and help me talk to Johnny's friend.
Why wouldn't we? Promised, didn't we?
Don't be afraid.
Don't know nothing.
I won't hurt you.
Where's Gran?
She's busy. Why are you scared to talk?
I'm not scared of nothing.
You're all scared of something. Would have told me about Johnny otherwise.
I'm worried about Johnny. He don't come around no more. Once, when we was mushroom picking, I saw his burrow. But Gran yelled at me. Said not to talk to strangers, because then kids go missing. She worries about Johnny too, though she says he's made up.
Where are you and your friend's parents?
Dad, some starved. Others were killed, like mine. One day, they went out at dawn to look for berries in the woods. Still some around back then. When I was coming home, I heard the yells, then laughing, went up and hid in the bushes near the woods. My mum yelled, and the soldiers laughed. Levi pawed down by the barn door. His head clean off. And then my mum...
It's all right. That's enough. I just want to talk to Johnny. He could know more than you.
Not gonna hurt him, right? Because he's real. He's not made up.
I'm not gonna hurt him.
Johnny used to be boy, because Gran liked listening to his songs. When we was picking mushrooms, Johnny said he saw a girl with ashen hair in the swamp.
Where can I find Johnny?
There's a little meadow on the edge of the swamp. This strange tree grows there. Look around. You'll see him.
Thank you.
What are you on about? Who said ask? Eh? Ugly word, ugly. Yeah. Small footprint. Johnny's been through here. Tracks lead to a burrow. Wonder what's inside.
Johnny? Don't be afraid. You're a Bucca? A Luton? Ah, a Godling. Not many of you left. I'm looking for a woman with ashen hair. Seen her? Tell me everything from the start. Where did you see her? What was she doing? It's important to me. Why not? You know the kids from the clearing well? Don't be afraid. Not gonna hurt anyone. This where you live? Cozy burrow. Good location. Must know about everything that happens in the bog. Doesn't bother you having monsters for neighbors? What's wrong? Can't talk? Why? Lost your voice? Can I help you somehow? Can't understand you. Try to explain it somehow. Want me to follow you? No choice, I guess.
Watch out!
Stay close to me. This the place? Let me look around. Something's on the ledge? Something that'll get you your voice back? Guess I gotta make this climb. This bottle.
A pack of pickled peppers by the Pontar.
Done celebrating?
My favorite words. Life without savoring the sound of surreptitious shenanigans is like licking snails through a clock. Thank you for this, noble whoever you are. Long be your life.
Hang on a minute. I helped you, now you help me.
Would you turn this beautiful act of altruism into a banal bartering of favors?
How'd you lose your voice?
One morning I awoke and opened my mouth for my usual bout of singing with the thrushes. Lo and behold, no sound escaped. I tried and tried, almost burst a blood vessel. Then I went to the village, because word has it, the new cunning woman works miracles. But people began crying out, "A smudger! A smudger!" and sick their dogs on me. Do I look like a smudger to you?
Not a bit.
Well, I thought not.
so it must be the crone's doing. Who else would curse me? Blackbird friend of mine located my voice, but I was helpless to retrieve it.
Couldn't ask a raven friend to just give you the bottle?
Ravens serve the crones. They don't help no one.
How do you lock someone's voice in a bottle? Just wondering.
As am I, especially as mine's a voice to crown all voices. Sometimes it's like a forest brook, at others like a roll of thunder. And let's be honest, I talk enough to fill 3 barrels or more.
Somebody used some powerful magic on you, as a prank or just to be mean. I'm looking for a young, ashen-haired woman. See anyone like that?
Did I ever? Remember it as if it were yesterday. Soon as I woke, I went to empty my bowels. My favorite part of the day. Defecating to the sunrise, downright glorious. Suddenly, heard a bang, so loud it couldn't have been me. And that lass appeared, out of nowhere. Young, ashen-haired, just like you said. Wounded and panting to boot. She raced off towards the children's hut. Quick as if the crones were after her. I yelled some unpleasantries. She disturbed my mourn. Sadly, I'd lost my voice, so I don't think she heard me.
I've been to the village in the swamp, met a woman who might have been a crone.
Did she seem confused to you?
Nuts, completely.
So I'm not crazy. That's no crone. That's the granny who takes care of the orphans. Claims the kids made me up. Me.
An orphanage in a swamp?
What do you have against swamps? Lived here my whole life, and I heartily recommend it.
What do you know about the crones?
They're as old as this forest. Cruel. Vindictive. Not to be crossed.
What if someone does cross them?
Might take his voice. Might take his life. Depends on their whim. They're nasty. Although, they care for this land and its folk in their own way. Supposedly, they always keep their word. But you must be careful what you ask for. Won't find them until they want to be found. See them until they want to be seen. But remember, they see and hear all that happens in the mire.
She ran off toward the orphanage. Kids could know something. Or the old woman who takes care of them.
Oh, that old hag don't speak to strangers. And you're a stranger.
Will she talk to you?
I have spoken to her. Got my ways. So be it. You helped me and I'm no bore. Come with me.
It's clear, not a crone in sight.
I need to sing to Gran. That ought to calm her.
Little Johnny softly gazed, fire waning pale. Hop! A spark jumped out and whispered, "Listen, I've a tale."
You, I got your voice back.
I did, though I seem to have lost an octave somewhere in the process. I shall look for it when I get home.
You're not allowed here, Johnny. You shouldn't have come.
Calm down, Gran. Don't get angry. It's not good for you.
The woman I asked about earlier.
Forgive me, Gran, but this fellow absolutely must talk to the ladies.
No, she's not allowed.
Please, it's important.
The fellow will be quiet. Gran, please hear me out. I found little Yagna when she got lost, did I not? Did I break Ginny's fever too? I did. I ask anything in return? No. Didn't even fuss about my stolen voice. Well, now I want something. Gran, help this fellow. Because otherwise he'll pester me day and night, even during potty time. His lass is missing. Mayhaps the ladies can help find her, eh?
Well, since you put it that way, Johnny, I'll help him. Come with me. Johnny's a good, good lad. Though the ladies don't like him. No. Foul creature, they say. Don't like him.
Who are the women in the tapestry?
Those are the ladies. Ladies lovely, with power o'er all, beseech I thee, answer my call. Before you a worm crawls, wretched and small.
How dare you disturb our rest, woman?
Someone speaking through you?
Good looking and clever, too. Where have you been hiding, boy?
I'm looking for the woman with ashen hair. I know you met her. Where is she?
Oh, he's impatient. Perhaps he only likes ashen-haired girls.
The young woman. She's my daughter by choice. I raised her.
If she's shapely, what does it matter?
Matters to me.
I believe we've hit a nerve. He's bubbling like well-fed yeast. Oh, that's how I like him.
It's clear you met her. Tell me everything.
That was blunt. Well, perhaps it's for the best. Tell me, have you got bollocks? Do you fear woodland beasts?
Oh, hard times are upon this white-haired one. Brother has turned against brother. The land is soaked in blood. Evil reigns stronger than ever before.
A dark power has surfaced near Dunwarren. It feeds on hatred and disdain. Destroy the beast, and we will be grateful. Tell you all we know about this ashen-haired maid.
Dark power? You need a knight errant, or a witch hunter, not a witcher.
The alderman of Dunwarren will tell you all. Remember to collect payment from him after you complete your task. And now our servant will bring you the dagger.
dagger? What for?
When the Alderman sees this dagger, he'll know we sent you. He'll aid with all.
I'll talk to the Alderman, but I can't promise anything.
Move, woman! Give the young man the dagger!
And you, White One, return only once you've completed the task.
Aye, mistress, right. On me way. Dagger. Gotta bring the dagger. The dagger. For you. Lady told me to give it you. Here it is. The dagger. Place the Alderman's payment on the stone. Stone bear, stone shear, stone nose, stone ears.
The spark expired.
The 33 thieves thought they'd draw the throne throughout Thursday!
Thank you.
Let's go!
Greetings. Nice village.
Aye.
A real pearl of the swamps.
If you say so.
You get by all right?
Aye, winter to winter. Somehow we survive.
Recognize this dagger?
Aye, master. I didn't know you belonged to them.
Don't belong to anyone. Down to business. I want to get this done quickly.
Ah, so that's how it's to be.
I'm supposed to help solve your problem. Tell me what it is. Just the essentials.
The war awoke an ancient power. An evil one that feeds on bloodshed. Nightmares haunt our nights and days. Folks sleepwalk from their homes, never to return. Under the tree on the Whispering Hillock they lie. Unburied all. Fathers, sons, daughters, and mothers. Folk are afeard to move them. You must go there. The dark powers must be cast off.
When did all this start?
3 years back. I remember, 'twas a warm day. Went to check the snares for Gay. pulled a hair from me trap. It grew dark all of a sudden, though it was nigh on noontime. Thought it was a storm at first. A squeal pierced the air, near burst me ears. The hair rotted in me hands, and the leaves shriveled and yellowed, though it were yet the start of summer. Times have been ill ever since. Folks' teeth turn black as charcoal. Women folk fight like polecats, bawling and brawling over nothing. The young'uns, born crippled, lame, fear and cursing. Long have we pled for the lady's help.
Need more details.
You must see for yourself. Me grand's mum whacked me crosswise for straying near the Whispering Illick. But what happens there now is a wonder.
A few times folk from round here gather to chop down the trees and burn the cursed soil back to use. None returned. The ground neath the weeds is white with human bones.
Ladies of the Wood don't know what this power is?
They know all. Old Thekla claimed they'd be punishing us. Folks stop respecting them. Some even call them witches. But must not be they, for they sent you.
I'll look around the Whispering Hillock.
You be careful, Master Witcher. Don't ye treat this evil light.
Don't you look at me.
The powers that protect me, they sense whence you come.
Fang bites.
Thank you.
medallion's humming. Place of power. It's gotta be Kid.
Be gone.
Why have you come? Why spill this blood? Are you here to grant me death? Or is my freedom your wish?
I saw women, children even, lying dead on this hill. Did they want to destroy you?
To nature. To the forest under earth. All death is alive. Every death is born. I cry. I wail. None is the same.
Who are you?
I abandoned my circle, where I had kept the balance. The Croons killed me and cursed my ghost.
Never heard of a druid circle of Velen.
I wander eternally through a maze of vows, helplessly sliding over rust.
Must know the Croons pretty well.
They are Velen's curse. They hear all through severed ears. They leave hair and twist lives. They take their strength from the broth of human flesh.
Why did they kill you?
The Croons want this land. They'd rule the wood alone. I stood in their way. I had to die.
I was attacked.
This is my prison. A fortress besieged. Murderers I await. And my forest protects me.
Murderers?
Murderous sisters. Killed my body. Now my soul they hunt, for I defy them.
You claim to be imprisoned. How so?
I am bound here, in fetters of magic. I wander endlessly, a labyrinth of thieves. The children, I know all. I know what awaits them. Free me, please. I must help.
If something threatens the orphans, I'll help them myself.
The children of Antigua, free me, please. I come the Gael, a gallop unchained. I shall save them. Only I can.
I saw women, children, lying dead on this hill. Did they want to destroy you?
To nature. I cry.
The Croons.
The sisters are older than the oldest trees. Velen is their realm. All life here serves them. The sisters live concealed. You will not find them. They hear all. You cannot hide.
Why do you think the kids from the meadow are in danger?
The sisters took them. They shall not return.
Where'd they take them? I can help.
It is done already. It cannot be undone. There are no rules to art ceremony. They shall all die. Let them be saved.
Save the orphans from the meadow. I'll help you.
I will find them. Free them. Open the door of my cage. Blood is my escape. A rite you must perform. With the black of raven feathers, the white of my bones, and the swift steed. A mare wild and free. Well, black as the depths of night. Such a beast, no other. Gather these and bring them here.
Got some raven feathers.
Find my remains and bring me a mount. moist.
Where'll I find your remains?
My bones. They lie in a solitary mound nearby, due west.
I'll gather what I need to free you, then return.
Gather and return to the Ilamic's depths, to the tree's rotten heart. Pierce my heart. Let blood flow to be born again. I must first be consumed.
Go now and return through the passage I have opened.
Looks like rain. Strange bones. Don't seem human to me. Hey there.
Hey-ya! Take it easy.
Ready. We can start.
Let me fly high, rain wings. Lay wings amidst the feathers. Place all beneath my heart. My heart you must pierce and break the steed.
Saw bodies of women and children in the woods. You've killed people who are no threat to you.
The wood killed them, for nature is blind. Death is never more than death.
For raven feathers.
Once I was free, I shall be free once more.
I offer your remains.
Once I was flesh, I shall be flesh once more.
What's new in the broad world?
Solved your problem. Just in case, though, avoid the Whispering Hillock for a while.
Cannot be. Where's something lurking there?
Believe me, you don't want to know.
What have you done?
Didn't have to fight anything or anyone. I simply freed the spirit.
You did what? Freed the evil so it can prowl the world as it will?
Did what had to be done.
And if it returns?
Ask the ladies of the wood to help. The crones, or the ladies of the wood as you call them, said to remind you about payment. Take it you know what they want?
Aye, I do. Give me the dagger. Be back soon.
There is payment. Take it to the ladies, will you?
What the hell was that?
'Tis our pact. You're a stranger. You don't know life here. It's honest pay for their protection.
So, all those ears in the woods...
Put it out your mind, Master. You soon be leaving, and we must tarry on our young'uns and their young'uns after him. No gods nor masters watch over Velen. The land is no man's. He who wants to survive must seek his own protectors.
Life, you're different than you were in the tapestry.
Well, bring it here. Disobeyed us once more.
We are forgiving creatures, but you allowed the children to escape.
They never wanted to flee. They liked it here. They played.
Your punishment must be harsh. Now silence! We must speak to the white-haired one.
The woman who cares for the kids.
She's a debt to pay. She is here by choice.
She's insane.
She knew what our pact entailed when she made it. We helped her. She promised to serve. Now she bears our mark. Belongs to us. Come. It is another woman who interests you. Speak, white-haired one.
You looked different in the tapestry.
We're all dressed up just for you.
If you only knew how much time we spent in front of the glass.
Do you desire us?
You know why I'm here. You know what I want.
You shall dream of us and return for what you reject. They always come back.
You used me to tame the Whispering Hillock. A lot of work.
Not free, brave soul.
Did you destroy the evil powers? Have you brought peace to our domain?
I freed the spirit trapped in the tree.
Hear that, sisters?
Traitor!
She took the children, but her!
We made a deal. I was supposed to help the villagers. I held up my end of the bargain. They're safe now.
So, a mockery you chose to outwit.
Whose spirit was trapped in the tree?
That of one who once cheated death. You freed an ancient power.
It will rise again. Elsewhere, beyond our reach, blood will flow once more.
What foolish things men sometimes do.
Our deal. I did my part. Now you do yours.
A word once given, we never break.
the girl. Mousy blonde. That's what they call it.
Thin as a rail. Terrified. Exhausted. She could barely stand, the poor thing.
We cared for her as best we could. Like she was our own daughter. Wasted affection. She proved a very naughty girl. Mischievous, stubborn, and selfish.
The young woman I seek never hurt anyone without cause.
You've not seen her long. She's changed for the worse.
Why'd she attack you?
She's no longer the girl you once knew. Wrath consumes her.
Don't believe you. They say you always keep your word, so tell me everything, exactly as it happened.
We shall tell you, brave boy. We knew someone special was born. We met beast entrails, saw the omens.
We would glimpse her likeness, a mirage in a puddle. She came from the lower swamp. We knew not at first it was her the omens had spoken of.
A child of the Elder Blood, the same seed that would burst into flame.
She fell into our hands. Elder Blood!
The blood of the Tempress. The table set, the cauldron bubbles.
We cannot! You know she is meant for him!
Imlareth will get her. He will, but not whole.
Well said. We'll just have a sample.
I'll take her feet. Lovely. Plump. Perfect for a broth.
Oh, I can taste it already. Very well. Get on with it! No! Oh, you'll regret that, girl. Regret it dearly.
Come back!
tried to butcher her like an animal and eat her.
Her blood, the taste brought back memories of our youth.
Elder blood. Extraordinary girl. But you know that. Such a shame she fled.
You tried to kill her. Can't forgive you for that.
Waste of words. Our fates are bound true. But now is not the time for that to bear fruit.
Now you shall chase shadows and wander amidst fog.
If you see her, she will be a mirage. And if you find her, if the girl will die to see you, handsome knight.
See you very soon.